7 miles outside Blackburn, but a long way off the beaten track, is the tiny hamlet of Cross Edge. In this remote location stands a former Methodist chapel with amazing views over the Lancashire countryside. Since it closed its doors to its congregation in the 1980s, the chapel and its contents have lain undisturbed. But now retired local farmer John Horman, whose land the chapel is on, is selling up.
Well, the chapel, it's been here since 1836. It says outside it was rebuilt in 1903, but all they really did was they made it a bit higher and they put a rather elaborate front on it. Once upon a time, it was very well attended, but in 1985, it closed. And it's been empty ever since.
Ooh, now you're talking. Right, this is very much my expert area, I suppose.
Dereliction.
Dereliction and yeah. Chapels. So what's to go?
Anything you can put your finger on.
Brilliant. Well, there's loads of things I can see here already. Obviously, there's a few of these benches. I've had dozens of these. Lots of lamps. We want all of those, if possible. And there's something over here that I cannot take my eyes off. I've got to ask. I've got to have it. That. Can I buy that?
You can.
Yes. That's made my year. The wages of sin is death.
No, to be fair, at least sins get some wages. At least it's getting paid.
It's a shame about that chip. Is there a bit of it lying around?
There isn't. It's as it was. Oh. It was lying underneath the pulpit.
Worship God. It's just the back is really quite wonderful and has got a huge amount of age to it as well. Flip the sign round. There's a much older signboard on the back. I reckon you can get that off, because it isn't the other side of the sign. It's just a thing that's been stuck on the back. Absolutely double whammy. So I can sell the one on the back and keep the one on the front.
Made in 1850, this austere wooden sign, inscribed with its Bible quotation warning, is typical of those that hung in Methodist chapels, so ministers could remind their congregation of the perils of bad behaviour. Its message may be grim, but a period piece like this has huge appeal. With its eye-catching black and gold design, and if Drew did ever decide to sell it, the sign could fetch around £500.
I love it.
It's very positive, isn't it?
What would you like for it?
Where do you want to start?
I'm going to give you a good bid straight off for it, because I'd really like it. Can I give you £200 for it?
225.
Thank you very much. Not for sale.
It is, he sold it.
Not now. Not now, that's mine. That's going in straight in my house. That's absolutely wonderful. That sign is one of the favourite things I've ever bought. You have to remember, we are dealing in moments in time. Little snapshots of a mentality, of a style, of a people, of an area. It's a snapshot of life. Be good or you're dead. Cobblers, rubbish. But that sign is going to take pride of place in my house, and it will remind me every day sin is good. The wages of sin is death, or a really good night out, whichever you prefer, really. What else we got? These things. These are great. I absolutely love these. And I particularly like this style.
Yeah.
But they're very unusual because they don't have, they're not finished. Yeah, it would have had another handle across the top of that.
To make it a bit thicker.
Yeah.
Made in the 19th century from mahogany, these long-handled boxes were passed amongst the congregation during services to collect donations. Once polished up, their simple, elegant forms would make highly desirable and useful household objects. They could be worth around £450.
What would you like for the collection?
Make an offer, Joe.
£150 for those? For that pile.
I'm not even going to argue.
Suppose we need to talk about the benches, don't we, really?
Those with the swing backs.
Yeah.
Are much older than these.
Have they got a date on them?
Not that I'm aware of.
We generally put these in the very late 19th century.
When they did this building up, they built it in 1836, 1903, they rebuilt it, they said. So they'd have to have somewhere to sit before, and yeah, I reckon they were sitting on those.
OK.
Probably made in the area in the late 19th century. These 26 benches can seat up to 5 adults each. Made out of planks of pitch pine, a strong and durable timber, and supported by a sturdy cast iron frame, they are fine examples of local craftsmanship. Their honest appeal and worn patina acquired over 150 years of use gives them character and charm, which could see them sell for around £4,550.
I'll start maiden bid, 40 quid each.
Make it 60.
We know what we're going to do, don't we? 50? We meet at £50 a pop. So I've spent about £1,500 on all of these things. They do look good in restaurants and pubs. They really do work. I'll tell you what you shouldn't do with these, though, is put them in your garden, because they're pine. They won't last 5 minutes. Even with yacht varnish, it doesn't work. The best thing I could do with them is cut them in half and turn them into two-seaters. Then they'll sell all day long. But that's more work, more time. So for now, we'll buy them, we'll polish 2 of each, put them online. They will be under £200, done. You know, they're not loads of money.
With a haul of great finds already in the bag, Drew heads to the upper gallery to continue the search.
So obviously I want to talk to you about these. The unusual matte opaline pendant lamps, nice little faux bronzing on the steel gallery. Sometimes we get them down and they're cracked inside the gallery.
Yeah.
People wind them up
too
tight.
Or they over-tighten them, yeah.
They're a nice little variant, these ones. They've got that sort of very strange ovaloid shape and then the nipple to the base. The gallery is faux-bronzed steel. They're a matte opaline glass as well, so there's no shine to them. They're matte, that is their finish. Again, casts a very nice light. There's 2 different sizes. They're all in pretty good condition so far. Without getting them down, we can't tell. I'd like to buy all of those.
Yeah.
Sure.
I'm quite sure.
I'll give you 50 quid each for these ones. And the ones downstairs, if they're not cracked, I'll give you a tenner apiece.
I'm not going to argue.
Are you happy with that? Mm. Thank you. Should we go and have a look down there? A nice little find, £50 apiece. That's about right in that condition. The thing I'm really keen to see is these lyres here.
Yeah.
They're very unusual, these, you know. Worth a few quid. These are definitely from the earliest incarnation of the chapel, so 1830s, yeah, if not a little bit earlier.
These extremely rare cast iron music or book rest stands are in the form of a small harp or lyre, a popular motif inspired by the classical Greek period. Large and strong enough to support heavy Bibles, their scrolling shape and geometric design gives them an elegance all of their own, and the time-worn paint adds to their period charm. Polished and restored, they could sell for around £1,000.
If I take the 3 and the posts, can I give you £300? I really rate them. I think they're fantastic things. Are they worth more than £300? I hope so. I think so. Are they an easy seller? Absolutely not. But just imagine if you've got a pretty fabulous kitchen and you bolt one of those onto your worktop for a permanent display of one of your books, isn't that quite wonderful as well? So they've got another way to go. There's bits of my job which are boring. The driving, for instance, you know, that there's hours and hours and days of driving here. And the rest of it's fantastic fun. And today's just been, you know, one of those days. I've managed to find something that I hopefully I'll keep forever, really speaks to me. And then these amazing lyre cast iron sections, just another tick. But what it does do is it educates you a bit more, a little bit more knowledge every time you see a building like this.
I've had a really good day. It's been enjoyable. He's been a very fair man to deal with. I'm going away very happy. He's taking the sign home with the wages of sin is death, and maybe some of it will rub off on him.